It's a writing challenge, Frittery, Jittery, today on The Right Focus. Checking in with the writing stage, I am at rough shape, 1,125 words, but this was a difficult day to get that many words. I'll explain in the post. Today's one of those frittery days when it's difficult to concentrate on the writing and it's impossible to pin down the reason so we can knock it totally away and get something done. I threw in some laundry and still couldn't settle to write. I mean, I know I have to write today. I need a day like yesterday. Yesterday, I almost reached double my needed word count. Yesterday was a wonderful day. Today, I struggled to write a half page after a couple of hours. Only 110 words. Sigh. I rearranged my workspace, total rearrangement, set up a different desktop, shifted the printer over and away, moved the two-drawer filing cabinet across the room beside the bookcase, unplugged and plugged in all the necessary wires, got another 3/4 of a page, only 165, 275 for the day, sigh. Went to choir practice, a long practice, for we had Maundy Thursday and Good Friday and Easter to prepare for. Came back with very little time to write, wrote 3 3/4 pages. Total word count at 1,125, 850 words in less than an hour. After struggling the whole day, sigh. Granted, today's scene was a difficult one. Tomorrow should be easier. Got the difficult conversation between the dual primaries completed. Well, half completed. They can't have the other part of the difficult conversation until after the ordeal scene. But we're moving, and that's lesson 42. Keep moving on. Writing the scenes that are hard as you reach them. Otherwise, when you reach the end of your rough draft, you have all horribly hard scenes ahead of you in order to finish it. No wonder so many newbies and wannabes never finish manuscripts if they procrastinate about the hard scenes and never get to writing them. Here's part 2 of today's lesson. Keep trying for that daily word count, even if you have to come back to it numerous times. Even if your brain doesn't want to settle to writing because the scene will be horribly hard. Keep moving. Keep trying. Get there. And when the evening draws to a close, don't spend excess time on a blog. Get some sleep. What inspirational quotation did I start the day with? Salvador Dali, have no fear of perfection. You'll never reach it. That should be liberating for all artists. What did I conclude with at the very, very end of the day? After I had written my total of 1,125 words and the blog post, Sylvia Plath said, "The worst enemy to creativity is self-doubt. You have to keep trying. You have to keep moving. You have to get there." Thanks for listening to The Right Focus, a podcast for writers at all levels, hosted by M.A. Lee, with assistance from Remy Black and Edie Ruins, all from Writers, Inc. Books. Our focus is productivity, process, craft, and tools. Show notes for this and other episodes can be found on therightfocus.blogspot.com. Write to us at winkbooks@aol.com. Our podcast episodes are running short this month, but usually they last as long as it takes to fix a quick dinner, drive a short commute, or take a brisk walk. Daily in April, we're bookcasting Write a Book in a Month by Remy Black, 2 in the trilogy Inspiration for Writers, copyright 2020. Take lessons from today's episode and write on. It's a writing challenge, Frittery, Jittery, today on The Right Focus. Checking in with the writing stage, I am at rough shape, 1,125 words, but this was a difficult day to get that many words. I'll explain in the post. Today's one of those frittery days when it's difficult to concentrate on the writing and it's impossible to pin down the reason so we can knock it totally away and get something done. I threw in some laundry and still couldn't settle to write. I mean, I know I have to write today. I need a day like yesterday. Yesterday, I almost reached double my needed word count. Yesterday was a wonderful day. Today, I struggled to write a half page after a couple of hours, only 110 words.